Hi guys, welcome to my channel, I'm John. Today I'm going to share with you how to create an abstract AI face animation in Blender 3D 3.0 alpha version using geometry nodes. Okay, so without further ado, let's get started. Okay, first we need to design our instance object before we jump into geometry nodes. So select the default cube, press N to toggle the properties panel, change the dimension to 0.15 for x and y axis, 2.65 for Z axis, and then press Ctrl A and apply the scale. Then go into edit mode and we can start to make some simple design on top of the cube. Okay, then we can add some material onto it as well. Let's select four of these faces. Go to material properties tab, press the plus button and click new to add a new material. Then click assign to assign it, change the surface to emission color and change the strength to 10 maybe. And then select these faces at the bottom, press shift S and select cursor to selected. Exit the edit mode, go to object and set the origin to 3D cursor. Then let's duplicate another one, then remove this emission color. So we have one with emission color and one without the emission color. Then duplicate a few more. Select all of them and press M to add them into a new collection. Let's name it Instant Object. Press OK. Then press this button to hide it. Okay, next we can start create the face using geometry nodes. So press Shift S and move the cursor to the origin. Then press Shift A and add a plane. Resize the plane to 10 meter by 10 meter. Then press Ctrl A and apply the scale. Split the screen. Go to Geometry Node Editor. Click New to apply a new geometry node to the plane. Pin it. In the Geometry Node Editor, press Shift A. Go to Point and add a point instance. Then select the collection. Untick the whole collection and select our instance object. Then let's add a joint geometry node. We need to join the plane with the instance object together. And currently we have only 4 instant objects grown on this plane. So in order to get more instant objects grown on the plane, we need to subdivide it. So press Shift A, let's go to Mesh and add a Mesh Subdivide. Put it before the point instance. Change the level to 6. And then we can start to add our texture map into geometry node. So press Shift A again, go to Attribute and add a Attribute Sample Texture. Add it before the point instance. Click New and name the texture AI Face. Press Enter, or you can put any name you like, it doesn't matter at all. In the mapping column, select UV map, and for the result, we put scale. We want the texture to affect the scale of our instant object. Now there's nothing here because we haven't added any texture onto it. Press this button to jump to texture tab. Go to image, click open. So this is actually a depth map. So what it does is, it is actually reflect the human face with just black and white. So the white point is represent the position that is closer to the camera, and the darker area is further from the camera. So you can actually find this depth map on Google, or you can also download this image in the description below. So double click to open it. And now we can see the depth map has affect the instant object. The deeper color on the depth map will make the instant object smaller, and the brighter color will make the instant object larger. And then I think we can try to increase the subdivision. I want to bring the instant object closer. So let's increase to 7. Then currently the instant object is overlapping each other. So let's add a point scale to make the instant object smaller. Add it before the point instance. Change the type to float and the factor to 0.6. Okay, next we can start animate it. So what I'm going to do is, I want to set up an empty sphere as a controller to control the animation. The instant object that touched by the empty sphere will be bigger, and the instant object outside of the empty sphere will be smaller. Okay, so to do it, let's add an empty sphere. Drag it into the geometry node editor. So when the empty sphere touch the instant object, in order to make the instant object become smaller or bigger, we need to have two set of value, which is the maximum size of the instant object and the minimum size of the instant object. Okay, so let's grab the attribute sample texture and make it as the maximum size. So let's remove the scale and create a new attribute by name it maximum size. And then for the minimum size, let's add an attribute fill node. Change this to vector. Change the value of x and y to 1. And then we store this value into a new attribute. Let's name it minimum size. So let me explain a little bit about this. Later, when we finish set up everything, the instant object that touched by the empty sphere will trigger the value of the maximum size here. Then, the instant object that not touched by the empty sphere will trigger the value for minimum size here. Okay, now we need to add an attribute mix to put both of the attributes together. Hover the maximum size and press Ctrl C to copy it, and then press Ctrl V to paste it at the attribute A column here. And then same for the minimum size. Copy and paste it at the attribute column B. And then type scale in the result column. We want it to affect the scale of the instant object. Okay, now if we play with the factor, when we slide the factor to the right, it will trigger the minimum size here. That's why it's nothing, because we set our z-axis for minimum size to 0. And if we push it to the left, it will trigger the maximum size here, which is the final outcome we want. And now I want to make the empty sphere, this empty sphere, to affect the factor here. So to do it, we need to let Blender know the position of the instant object and the location of the empty sphere. So let's add an attribute vector math. Put it before the attribute mix. Change the operation to distance. And then for the attribute A column, select position. Because we want to get the position for each of the points on the plane, which means by doing this, we are also getting the position of the instant object as well, because our instant object is cloned on this point. Okay, then change our attribute B to vector. Then we grab the location of the empty sphere and connect it to vector distance. This is to let Blender know where is the location of the empty sphere. And then we store the result to a new attribute. Let's call it distance. Then next, I want to make the scale of the empty sphere to affect the instant object as well. Okay, so let's add an attribute math. Put it before the attribute mix, change the function to divide, then hover the distance, copy it, and paste it at the attribute A column, then change the attribute B to float, then connect the scale of the empty sphere to the B, then output and override the result to distance as well, then go to attribute mix, change the factor to attribute, then copy the distance and paste at the factor column here. So now, let's grab our empty sphere and touch the plane. So now we can see the instant object only appear inside the empty sphere, and the instant object outside of the empty sphere is disappeared. Then next, we can start to animate the empty sphere. So select the empty sphere, go to output properties tab, change the frame start to 0, and the frame rate to 30 frames per second, drag the time indicator to 0, scale the empty sphere smaller until all the instant object disappeared. And then let's add a keyframe to the scale. Then click this button to jump to the end frame. Then scale the empty sphere bigger until it covers the entire plane. Let's put 30. And then add another keyframe. Then I think we can move the plane slightly higher. Let's add a transform node. Add it before the joint geometry node. Change the translation Z to 0.02 maybe. And let's make the plane bigger as well. Change the scale of X and Y axis to 3. Okay, next, I want to add some ripple effect to the animation. So to do it, let's add an attribute color ramp. Put it before the attribute mix. Hover and copy the distance and paste it at the attribute and result column. Let's add another two color. Change this to white color. This one to black. This one remain white. And then let's adjust it a little bit. And then let's change this to east. Then now let's drag the time indicator to check the animation. Okay, everything looks good for me. So if you want to add more ripple to the animation, you can play around with the color ramp here. You can add more black and white color onto it. Okay, next, we need to add lighting and set up the camera to finish the scene. Press this button to jump to the end frame. Then press Ctrl Alternate and Numpad 0 to frame the view you are looking at. Select our camera and let's adjust the position a little bit. Then go to the camera properties tab and change the focal length to 150. Then I want to animate the camera as well. Select the camera and add keyframe for the location and rotation. Drag the time indicator to around 30 frames. Then press Shift Tilt to adjust your camera. I want to zoom in the object a little bit and I want the object in the center. Then add another keyframe for the location and rotation again. Then select this keyframe and drag it to zero. Okay, now we can start setting up the lighting. So press this button to jump to the end frame. Go to Render Properties tab, change the render engine to Cycles and the device to GPU Compute. Turn on the render preview. Let's turn this to 3D viewport as well, so we are easy to see. Press numpad 7 to see the top view. Then I want to remove the existing lighting. Then press Shift A and add an area light. Press G followed by Z, move it higher. Let's put 8 meter maybe. Then go to the object data properties, change the power to 600 and the size to 5 meter. The bigger the size, the softer shadow you will get. Then next, I think I want to make the material a little bit darker. So let's select the plane, go to Material Properties tab, add a new material, change the base color to a gray color. Or you can play with other color you like as well. Then I want to copy this material and paste it to the face as well. So let's activate our instant object again. Select the instant object and paste the material. Do it for 3 other objects as well. Then deactivate it again and we can start to render the animation. Go to Render Properties tab, go to Denoising, activate the NLM. Then go to Output Properties tab, select where you want to output your file and select your format. I'm going to leave it PNG for now. Go to Render and render the animation. Then we done it. So if you like my video, please subscribe and see you in the next video. Bye.